In this video, I'm going to show you how to be able to stream in 1440p 60 frames per second to YouTube utilizing OBS Studio. And I'm even going to share the best settings so that way your stream looks smooth. So once you have OBS Studio open, you're going to come to the bottom right and you're going to select settings. We're going to first come to the tab where it says stream. And then you want to make sure for the service we have YouTube RTMP selected. And then we want to go ahead and select use stream key advanced. So now we need to go ahead and get our stream key, and to be able to stream in 1440p, we need to make a special stream key for YouTube. So to be able to do this, we're gonna come to our YouTube account. We're gonna go ahead and click on this crate, go live. And once you're here, you're gonna be brought to a dashboard just like this. On the left-hand side, you wanna select stream. This is gonna bring you to the control room. And what you wanna do under stream key, you wanna hit this little drop down and you wanna select create new stream key. We can name this new 1440p key. You'll scroll down to where it says turn on manual settings. For resolution, we want to select 1440p and you want to turn on 60 FPS option. You'll select create. Once you've done that, you want to go ahead and select copy on the stream key. We'll come back here to OBS. We'll paste that stream key directly in there, and then we'll check here, ignore streaming service settings recommendations, select apply, and now we can go ahead and begin this actual process. So now here we want to select settings, come back here to where it says output, and now we want to come to where it says streaming. So here's where we're going to select our video encoder. So if you're on a Mac, you'll use a Apple VT H.264 hardware encoder. And then if you're on a Windows, you're gonna wanna make sure that you utilize your NVIDIA NVIC, either H.264 or H.265, but you wanna make sure you utilize your graphics card. So next we're gonna come down to where it says rate control, CBR. We're gonna wanna make sure this is at about 13,000. So to be able to know if you can support a 13,000 bit rate, you need to have at least about 30 upload to be able to kind of support this, right? So to be able to check to see what speed you have, you wanna come to speedtest.net, and I'll put a link in the description of this video. And once you hit go, it's gonna give you your download and your upload. You want this number here to be at least 30 or more for you to be able to support a 13,000 bit rate. So I have 914, so I have more than enough to be able to support that. And if you do, you can go ahead and proceed and move forward with what I have here. So we put that at 13,000. Keyframe interval is gonna be at 2. Profile is going to be at high, and then you want to have your B frames, you want to have this selected. If you're on Windows, your setting is going to be a little bit different. You're still going to have your bit rate at 13,000. Your keyframe interval is going to be at 2. Your presets are going to be at P6 slower, better quality. Tuning, you're going to have it at high quality. Your multi-pass mode is going to be at 2 passes. Your profile is going to be at high. I would remove look ahead, especially if you don't have the GPU to be able to support it. Cycle visual tuning, definitely have it on. GPU at 0, and then max B frames at 2. So once you have that there, the next thing that we need to go ahead and set up is our video settings. So we'll simply select apply, and now you'll come here to where it says video. This is gonna be super important here. So for your base canvas, this is either gonna be 1920 by 1080. So this is gonna be what you want to be able to stream on for your monitor, right? So if you have a 1080p monitor, you would select here for 1080p. If you have a 1440p, we would go ahead and put the 1440p selection here. Or if you have a 4K monitor, you can have it here for that base canvas resolution there. I'm gonna keep it at 1080 just simply because that's what I want my canvas to be inside of OBS. And then the output scale, this is super important. If you want to be able to stream in 1440p to YouTube, we need to go ahead and do the output scale to be 2560 by 1440. So you have that there. If these two numbers don't match, you want to make sure you select 36 samples as your option here. And then we want to do 60 FPS here as well. And then we'll simply select OK. And now you'll see here that if I go to my gameplay, once we go ahead and hit start streaming and I hit start, so we'll stream over to YouTube. So you can see that the quality is going to be at 1440p and it's going to be extremely smooth. So we'll see here that we're now live. We'll have excellent connection. We'll see here that we'll now be here. And now to be able to view this, we can go ahead and open this here on YouTube to be able to see what this is gonna look like. Hit paste. And now you'll see here that we are going to be live. And when we come here to the quality, you're going to see that we have 1440p 60. And you can see that the quality is spot on, looks just like it would on the actual console. Now, if you want to be able to go ahead and set up all of your overlays inside of OBS to make your stream look professional, you want to go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on doing just that. I'll see you guys in the next video.